one wonders if this is going to last. I mean, what do you think, Selena? Do you think this is sort of a new moment where creepy men are getting the message that, hey, you know, this is behavior that you're going to be publicly shamed for, if not tried for?
If there are creepy men out there that aren't quaking in their boots right now, then shame on them, because I don't think this stops with the people that are at the top, as you said, right? I think that people, whether they're in business, whether they're in school, you know, social media gives people the outlet to be able to say, hey, this happened to me, this is the guy or the woman that did it to me, and this needs to stop. I think we're at the tip of the iceberg, and I don't think this ends for a while until people realize that certain behavior is just not acceptable, it's unwanted, and it shouldn't be, it's awful.
I think it's interesting, the New York Post calls it Franken slime, with that now infamous picture of Democratic Senator Al Franken. And I think what's interesting to me, at least, is that he remembers the kissing episode, the unwanted kissing episode, differently than she does. And it might be that we have to start talking about this stuff so that, so that men know that what he thought was maybe normal is just not normal.
You think he thought that was normal?
I don't know.
Shoving his tongue down someone's throat?
I know. I keep saying, look, no woman wants her.
I know.
No,
can Franken survive this, Selena?
Yeah, that's what I wonder.
Does he stay in the U.S. Senate? More 50-50 chance. His aspirations to become president? Not so much.
Yeah, his reputation is pretty dangerous here.
Members in his own party taking the money that was donated to their own campaigns from his super PAC and donating it to women's programs. And people had no problem walking away from him yesterday. I found that fascinating and admirable for the members of the Democratic Party who did that.
And quickly, and the House passed a big tax rewrite, the first one in a generation. Yesterday was such a crazy day. When you come back, we'll talk about taxes, okay? We'll talk about taxes and that spat between Sherrod Brown, Senator Sherrod Brown, and Orrin Hatch about who, whether this is fair.
All right, speaking of which, the House passed its version of a tax bill earlier yesterday in a historic vote. No Democrats backing the bill, but the real fireworks over in the Senate and the Finance Committee leading up to its vote on the Senate's version of a $1.5 trillion Republican tax plan late last night. The measure passed by a 14-12 vote strictly along party lines. Republican Chairman Orrin Hatch and Democratic Senator Sherrod Brown getting into a shouting match, with Brown questioning why the richest Americans need tax cuts.
I get kind of sick and tired of it. Well, true, it's a nice political play.
Well, Mr. Chairman,
it's not true.
With all due respect, I get sick and tired of the richest
regular order, Mr. Chairman.
Getting richer and
regular
richer.
Order.
We do attack
regular order.
Middle class.
Wait a minute. Regular order.
And over and over again. How many times do we do this before we look at this?
Listen, I've honored you by allowing you to spout off here. And what you said was not right. That's all I'm saying. I come from the lower middle class originally. We didn't have anything. So don't spew that stuff on me. I get a little tired of that crap. And let me just say something. If we worked together, we could pull this country out of every mess it's in.
Perhaps a preview of the battle that lies ahead. The bill, which includes a repeal of the individual mandate in Obamacare, now heads to the Senate floor, where action is expected after the Thanksgiving break.
All right, the Senate.